Hi, this is Rene Guadalupe. Welcome to this video. My personal mission in life is to inspire people the world over to be resilient and to be the very best at whatever they do. The reality is, in this day and age, the average person will always survive. Only the very best will thrive and succeed. Now, let me get on with this video by asking you a question. Have you ever wondered why some people read a book and went on to become wealthy while thousands or even millions read the same book and they are still struggling? Let me put it another way for you. Have you ever seen people who don't seem to have one quarter of your education or knowledge, who are living large and doing extremely well while you may be struggling, while you may be having a hard time trying to achieve your dream? Now, is it because the person happens to be in the right place at the right time? Is it because the person is actually lucky? Well, sometimes there may be some truth to that. However, I believe if you want to be lucky, become the very best at what you do. Okay? That's how you get lucky, when you are absolutely the best. And in order to be in the right place at the right time, well, you've got to be at many places all the time. All right. If it's not luck or being at the right place at the right time, what is it? Great question. Let me answer it with a powerful metaphor for you. You see, this is my tennis racket. All right, you see it? These are my tennis balls inside this container. Now, I know what you may be thinking. I didn't know he played tennis. Well, as a matter of fact, I don't play tennis. I don't even know how to hold a racket. So the question is, why do I have tennis balls and a racket? Why? That's a great question. The guys I run with every Saturday on the trail, we run, we probably do 10 miles or sometimes we do 8 miles on the trail running together. One of them, Jerry Lee, gave me the racket and the tennis balls. That's great. Jerry gave me the racket and the tennis balls. They have been in the trunk of my car now for about a year, 1 year in the trunk of my car. Let me ask you this question. Because I drive around with a racket and some tennis balls in the trunk of my car, does that make me a tennis player? Really, does that make me a tennis player? The answer is obviously no. Now, when do I become a tennis player? Well, you are smart. When I actually get on the court to start practicing and playing, when I start taking action. Until then, I am a spectator. That's what I will always be. Here's my point. Most people in life are spectators. They are not players. Very few people actually are players. The spectators read a book and they attend a seminar. They get excited in the moment. But then they don't go on the court to play and put into application what they learn. The players do just the opposite. My question to you is, are you a player or a spectator? Have you ever noticed how the players sometimes criticize the, not the players, the spectators criticize the players. Have you ever noticed that? Have you ever heard the fans or the spectators screaming and yelling and cursing at the players for their mistakes? I am talking about actually the player haters. Now, this video is not about the player haters, okay? I just want you to be a player. Really? Now, take a good look at your knowledge, degrees, all the degrees you have, and whatever education you have. I want you to take a good look. Do you know that they are your racket or your tennis balls? Yeah, they are your racket or rackets or your tennis balls. Just like me and my tennis balls and my racket, I was carrying them for a long time in the trunk of my car. So that's what you are doing. You are carrying all this knowledge, degrees, and all that in the trunk of your mind, your brain. You know, it's time to play. Before I wrap up, let me say this to you. In life, you are either creating or you are consuming. So it's either you are a creator or you are a consumer. When you are creating, you are playing. You are being a player when you are creating. But when you are consuming, you are a, guess what? Spectator. Which one do you want to be? The reality is, every time you are learning, you are consuming. You are being a spectator. Guess what? Spectators don't make money. No, they don't make any money. They spend money. The players, on the other hand, they make money. Because, you know, the spectators have to pay to go see the players. Got it? Do you understand? Great. Here's the question you should always ask yourself while doing anything. You should say to yourself, am I being a player or am I being a spectator? Right now, you are being a spectator because you are watching me, right? It's time to play. Oh, by the way, you don't have to start big. Maybe all you can do is learn how to hold the racket. But start somewhere. Just do something that makes you feel you are playing. All right? Go play and press on. Take care.